Alright. So when people started making cities and stuff and getting together and all living in one area, the water would get bad, you know, because of... Anyway, beer was sanitary and they could drink it without getting sick. You know, like Jake, he can drink water without getting sick. I feel like I'm rambling and I hope this doesn't make the cut.
No, but it will. But no, go ahead and we're listening because this is important.
But anyway, beer is a very important contributor to the reason why humanity is as big as it is now. So thank God for beer.
We like beer.
Good morning. Well, I don't know if it's morning for you, but at least for me it is. It's actually 6:45. I left the house about an hour and 15 minutes ago, heading to Dallas Left Field Airport to catch a flight to LA to ride tonight in Santa Maria, California. Then I'll have a day off and then I'll be in Salt Lake City for another rodeo and then head home on Sunday.
Ran into this guy right here. You know it's June 1st, right?
I didn't bring a razor. It still looks good though.
Welcome to Cali, home of Vanilla Ice, Drew Barrymore, and Matt Cohen.
Right now we just made a pit stop on the way to Santa Maria. We got a couple hours to burn. I can't even tell if you can see me. And so we figured we'd go check out the beach. Don't really have a swimsuit. We're in a sketchy tunnel. Started from the house this morning at 5 o'clock and it's 6 o'clock back home, so it's always pretty awesome being behind the buck and shoot surrounded by legends such as Caleb Bennett and his
one protein bar
trying to keep up with this guy.
Oh my gosh,
nothing but gains, right?
I could turn gay right
come
now.
Come on, french fry.
Here's my take on it. There's a lot of guys here that have been on that horse before. I never have.
I
don't feel bad.
I've never been on that horse before, ever.
Hey, it's a good pen of horses. They're all gonna be good today.
He's just
beautiful day. Beautiful afternoon.
How to fix your pants in the hole?
Just admiring the stash. Especially the fact that it's June 1st and you still got it on. That's a trooper.
I'm proud of it. Evan?
I'm a little proud of my stash.
Well, everybody's getting ready, so I'm gonna go ahead and get ready as well. This is a televised rodeo, so I won't be able to do much filming this evening for you guys. Wish me good luck, and we'll see you in a bit. Hey, so it's 2:15 and we're back in LA. My ride actually went pretty good. I ended up winning the Champions Challenge with the Indy 5.5 and I actually got somebody to film it with my phone, so you guys get to see that. It's been 23 hours since I started the day, and all four of us are gonna try to catch a little nap for a couple hours and then catch a flight early for Salt Lake City. We'll see y'all tomorrow.
Oh, wow.
You didn't know you were getting four of us.
Squeeze in here.
Six a.m. We're gonna sleep for how long, Bill? How long did we sleep?
2.5 hours.
2.5 hours. We're heading
fresh
to,
as frog here.
Into LAX to catch our flight to Salt Lake City. And this is Zombie Nation right here. All of us hated our alarms this morning. I caught myself putting soap on my toothbrush instead of toothpaste. I literally opened my shower gel and was about to put it on my toothbrush. Oh, this feels great, Bill.
I don't know what to do right now.
By the way, this is the world's most expensive valet. $35 for 3 hours. Gotta love LA. Hey, so we just got off our flight, grabbed a quick lunch, and now we're heading up the mountains of Utah to check out this place called Donut Hole Waterfall. And I've got LaShad, Jake, Bill, and just enjoying a day off. Well, for most of us, a day off. It's pretty cool. Out here, isn't it, Bill?
Ow.
Oh, my ankle. Hey, so I'm with Jake Brown, and Jake Brown actually has to ride tonight at a rodeo here in Utah. Earlier, we had a conversation about going to eat somewhere, and you were concerned about eating Mexican because he's got to ride tonight and because he didn't want to be sick. So, what does Jake do when he gets to the mountain?
Refreshing.
Yeah, we'll see in about 5 hours or 2 hours how that goes.
I sold my soul to the devil, said you don't need your heart in this world full of trouble where the madness won't stop. And they take advantage and they run for the hills, cause life is hard and they swallow the pills, being lonely. She can't fly. I screamed out, can you forgive me? Before she said goodbye. I go into darkness before I try.
Starting to see people. Must be close.
Getting by.
Well, this is what the falls look like usually. And you can actually go inside the cave, but it's snowmelt season, so we won't be able to go in.
Saturday morning, we are in Orem, Utah. We just had 12 hours of sleep, finally caught up, and we're about to head to Spanish Fork to do a little bit of shooting and get ready for tonight's Champions Challenge.
Putting his other bag up.
Putting his other bag up.
Yeah, ear plugs are right here.
What do you think so far?
Oh, just knocking them dead. The birds are safe around here.
This was a lot of fun, but I gotta give it to Bill. He beat me. Bill beat me by one. So bragging rights for the next 6 months, probably for Bill.
It's all that matters.
But I beat all of them.
And Chad just, we couldn't have a Chad here. We're wearing sunglasses because we're crying. Chad has been just killing us.
Yeah, even without his Chris Kyle t-shirt, he still managed to beat us. I don't know how, but.
Good job.
I'm on my phone, sorry.
So we're buying the chutes in Spanish, getting ready. It's about an hour and a half before the rodeo, and this is another televised rodeo, so not really allowed to have the camera out behind the buck and chutes and all that, but we'll be rebels and try to have somebody film us with cell phones. Anyway, it's been a good day. Got a bunch of good guys here hanging out with us, and just always lovely to be out in Utah with my Bill. Bill.
Hey! What are you doing with me picking my nose, man? I had an itch. Get out of here with that thing! Am I doing it now?
Yeah.
I liked it better when the thing was facing me so I could see what's happening. This next segment is called Your Favorite Rodeo Announcer Line.
Now this cowboy coming out of shoot number 3. He's a gym rat. He's a member of the PTA, and I'm not talking about the Parent Teacher Association. I'm talking about a prime time athlete.
Stroke, stroke, big daddy long stroking.
Wait, I'm not camera ready. This cowboy has been to the bay window at every rodeo to pay his entry fees.
There are no borders in rodeo, especially when Evan Jayne's up.
You got one for us?
Favorite rodeo.
Well, let me put my pants on. Kick the tires and light the fires.
How many of you came here today just to see the mutton busted?
Hey, so I'm back in Texas, my place in Glen Rose. Sometimes you draw the best horse and you turn around and go to the next rodeo and you pretty much draw the worst. And that's what happened to me this weekend. In Santa Maria, I had a great horse and then turn around, go to Spanish Fork and no bueno. I'm gonna get to editing because I have lots and lots and lots of footage to edit in order for you to see the video that you just saw. So because this is the end of it, and subscribe to the channel, that way you get an update every time. Every time I come out with a new video, you get an email or you get some kind of update. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully we'll see you soon. We'll talk to you soon. We'll do this again. All right. Peace.